they're up against some pretty stiff competition. Dick, let's see how they'll fare in this Final Four matchup between the Boston University Terriers and the Baylor Bears.
It's showtime, baby. Let's get the intros and get this one started.
You got it, partner. So without any further delay, let's get this one started. The Bears, by all accounts, should have an easy time of it tonight, Dick Vitale. How do they ensure that victory, though?
They should listen to me and follow the simple keys, baby. First of all, play at your own tempo. Don't get into a run-and-gun game, baby. Second, make sure you eat up the boards. Finally, get out of those shooters. Challenge every shot.
Well, partner, I say let's get to the action on the court, and we'll see how this one plays out. Got the high pick. Unloads a three. Way off target. Both teams looking to get things going here.
Up and inside.
Trying to pack it inside. Tries for two. In and out. Trying to draw some contact.
That was awesome, baby.
Good defensive stance there against the spin move.
Well, the key is to beat him to the spot, and he did a great job. He anticipated that spin move.
On the elbow, they feed down to the low block. He beats him to the punch defensively.
What a terrific job. Footwork really excellent on the post play.
Inside, number 15 handles the feed. Tries the turn, the defense comes up with a play.
What a terrific play to stop that spin move.
They'll work it around the arc. Jumps in.
He ran his man into the screen and dropped in a beautiful bucket.
Shows patience, waiting for the reset. Fed the low block. And up and drains the shot.
Oh, I love this guy. I love him.
Number 13 is feeling good.
I love seeing players play with emotion and passion. There's absolutely nothing wrong with that.
Right in the circle. Off the rim and no good. Leaning in, trying to draw contact. Inside. He stole the ball. Great pressure there.
Fantastic ball pressure. The pressure got to the ball handler, and he lost it.
Number one receives the ball. Boy, terrible execution on offense. He keeps the dribble as they reset. Looking to move it around the perimeter. And there's a lazy pass. It's stolen away. Turnover. Will it turn into two the other way? Number 31 receives the pass. Good job defensively. Had him in the paint, but went elsewhere from three-point land. There was no doubt about that one. For the bucket, can't get the shot to drop. He'll regroup the offense. On the dribble, gives it up. He lets it go. It'd be nice if he could get some assistance out there. That young man is doing it all for his team right now.
Call this a one-man show, Brad. I don't know if it's a good thing or a bad thing.
The offensive guy now is gaining position down there on the low block, Dick.
I tell you, he gained big-time position by getting the good angle, the good arm entry, had the real extension.
He's not even looking for the open man, Dick.
They might need a quick T.O., baby.
They work the perimeter. And the ball goes out of play. I don't even know if you and I can find a seat in this place, Dick.
I'll tell you one thing, you get the home court advantage when you got a crowd like this. By the way, you and I have the best seat in the house.
Gave it up.
Oh, poor job. Poor job offensively. I'm coaching. He's sitting next to me as an assistant coach. He's pounding the ball with a deck. Where's he going?
Number 24 handles the pass. Number 24 picks up the foul. First personal foul. Looking for a good shot. He uses the shot fake. He shoots from right of the circle. He hits it. I want to thank you for joining us tonight with Dick Vitale and Aaron Andrews. I'm Brad Nessler. And the ball goes out of bounds. Comes defensively on him on the low block, Dick.
I tell you, three-quarter position, trying to deny, but then he does a great job of post position, spreading his body and getting the ball.
Takes care of the ball until the offense resets. Looking for a good shot. Goes up for two.
Great play to take that to the basket.
Working it around the perimeter. Here's a double team. Pump fakes. Leans in. And he scores despite the hack.
Coach looks on. Focused. A lot of intensity. A lot of emotion.
From right in the circle. Poor decision. He has no business taking that shot.
That shot was definitely ill-advised.
On the dribble, gives it up. Dick, not a bad drop step, but it doesn't work for him.
I tell you, just doesn't beat him to the basket. Not quick enough. And a great reaction by the defensive post player.
They work it around the perimeter. Gave it up for two. Perfectly executed. Kick it back outside. Thinks about the shot. Dickey's going to kick it back out there from down on the low block.
I tell you, a post player has to be able to read what the defense gives you.
And a momentary look from three-point land. He launches a three. Baylor have a nice little run going here. Can they keep it up, though?
No one's proven otherwise just yet, Brad.
That spin move not successful, Dick.
I tell you, great job by the defense not allowing them to make that turn.
And off the mark. He went for the steal in the post, and he missed it, Dick.
Oh, I'll tell you one thing. What a poor job defensively. He gambled.
He goes to the line for the first time. Gets the first. Second one is no good. Gets the rebound.
Getting that quick outlet pass is so important for the fast break.
Isolated on the outside. They're working around the arc, looking for the open jumper. He shoots from the top of the key. Way off target. They'd like to get it inside to the low block. Unable to so far. Nice job of packing it in defensively.
Yeah, really doing a great job packing it in, and a great job of anticipating that lateral pass.
Defensively, low block. Oh, nice job fronting him for the steal.
Terrific job creating the opportunity, and it really converts an offensive transition.
That's eight on the answer.
Got to take some pride on the defensive end.
He shoots from the top of the key. The Terriers have got to continue to get him the ball.
They need to keep feeding the ball. It's simple.
On the dribble, gives it up. Unloads. Off the rim and no good. Had an open guy in the post and went the other way. There's the fake. Tries to get the D to bite. Here's the toss back out from the post.
I tell you, coach's dream when your post player can be an exceptional passer.
Problem with that, when you front, if you don't get some backside help, you're in trouble.
Well, you got to get help because you got to see ball man. That's essential when you play on there and you front it.
Didn't like what he saw in the post and reverses the ball. Looking for the foul. Boston University are putting together a pretty good run here.
Execution's been the key, baby.
Tries for two.
Great play to take that to the basket.
Number 15 is asking the crowd for some encouragement.
I think he feels the importance of this defensive possession, Brad.
Way off target. Gave it up. There's a bad pass right to the defender. Number 24 makes a great move to draw the foul.
Let's go to the instant replay camera.
He's been making some great plays, but taunting? This crowd may be giving him some unwanted attention.
You've got that right, Brad.
With the free one. He gets it to go.
They've got a shooter spotting up on the three-point line.
He missed the guy in the post and goes the other way. Fires away. The Bears have a hot hand right now that's scoring for them at the moment.
Granny's on fire.
The skip pass is picked off. The outside trying to draw the foul, drops the bucket despite the harm.
Up and inside
on the dribble, gives it up for the bucket. They still don't score.
I think right now I've got to focus defensively.
Gave it up. Dickey's going to kick it back out there from down on the low block.
I tell you, a post player has to be able to read what the defense gives you.
He shoots from the elbow. Sinks it. Picked off. Here's the toss back out from the post.
I tell you, coach's dream when your post player can be an exceptional passer.
Swatted from behind.
Never saw him coming, Brad.
On the dribble, gives it up. Dick, I think there's a mismatch in the post.
It's definitely a mismatch.
10 on the shot clock. Looking for a good shot. Sets a screen for his teammate. You betcha.
That's a 9-zip run.
Let's go to the third member of our broadcast team. Here's Aaron Andrews.
Well, Brad and Dick, the leading team down here is very relaxed. I'm down by their bench, and the coaches are reminding them, despite the score, try and remain focused. Remember, it's the first half. Anything can happen, guys.
Thanks, Aaron. That was a definite blow to one team's composure. Let's see how or if this will affect the team. Fakes the shot with a jump hook, and he missed. Takes the pass in the paint. He rejects it. Here's a nice face up down in the low block.
Oh, he did a great job face up and then just attacked them and took it to the basket.
Jump hook from the low post. Can't get the shot to drop. Work it inside, and he tries a drop step. Defensively, nice job.
Great job using his footwork defensively to beat him to the spot.
Let's get back out on the floor.
Excellent spacing. That's so important to a good offensive set. It's even more important to have talented guards out there.
Yeah, that helps.
Ooh, look at the shot blocker. We got some contact. Nice hops.
Gave it up. Picks off the pass. Fast break opportunity here. Jumps into the defender. He keeps the concentration off the contact for the score. With a deep shot from outside. Off the rim and no good. Catch. Nice execution on the spin.
I'll tell you, great spin move to the basket.
On the dribble, gives it up. He puts it up. Way off target. Gave it up.
Tempo of the game, really important here. You want to establish some good tempo.
On the dribble, gives it up.
Dumping inside.
Got a guy right on him on the pass. For two, he's not getting himself in position for the good shot.
Yeah, it's a little bit too much. 1-on-1.
That spin move's not going to work against this defense.
That's a no-no, baby. Defensive player beats him to the spot. That's spacing.
Defense giving some room. There they come with a double team to stop it. From right at the circle. Too strong. Work the perimeter.
Spacing so important. Get 15 to 17 feet apart.
Controlling the ball. Stolen away. Tries for two. Baylor have gotten themselves into a bit of a rhythm on offense, Dick. They're really on a nice run right here. For the bucket and off the mark. Goes up for two. In and out. Number 24 is pounded on his way up.
I can't emphasize it enough, Brad. It's important to get to the charity stripe.
First shot, good. Misses the second shot. Number 50 draws the personal. Oh, and he's not going to be happy with that call.
What a silly foul right there, but look at his face. His facial expression tells it all.
He'll attempt two shots.
Concentrate. Got to concentrate on that free throw line.
Makes the foul shot. They're working around the perimeter. For two. Doesn't go. The ball goes out of play. I've seen you out there with pom-poms, Mr. Vitale, but not looking that good.
I tell you what, don't look that good. I can't dance like that, baby.
Looking for a good shot. They work the perimeter. He dials long distance. They really seem to be letting this one get away, Dick.
Yeah, there's been a breakdown somewhere. They need to talk this one over, Brad.
Side. Top of the circle.
If they can get off some good shots and easy buckets, they might turn around this awful stretch of shooting for them, Brad.
Easier said than done, though, right now, Dick. Here's a spin down to the low block.
I tell you, he's got a variety of moves. He used the sky hook, the jump hook, now the spin move to the goal.
Gave it up. Puts up the shot. Shots off the mark. Working around the perimeter. Looking for contact. Basket falls despite the contact. Fronts him first, Dick, and then works behind.
Yeah, he's playing from behind him because that tells me right there they don't respect him as an offensive player. And he made an error, obviously, but they don't have the great respect, so they're saying, you know what? Let him get the ball and let him try to beat us.
And has it rejected.
Defense did a great job with that blocked shot.
Dribble, gives it up on the inside. They go inside and now back outside.
I tell you, inside outside action always works.
He beats him to the punch defensively.
What a terrific job. Footwork really excellent on a post play.
Here's the toss back out from the post.
I tell you, coach's dream when your post player can be an exceptional passer.
Working it around the perimeter. In the paint. Tries for two. Easy one. Shot clock is dead. Moving it around the perimeter. Lets it fly.
Great execution. That's offensive efficiency at its best.
Going to move it around the perimeter. Gave it up. He had to hurry that one. And he makes the three. At halftime, the Bears are ahead by 13. Nick, what have you selected as the EA Sports Play of the Half?
Buzzer beater at the half. Can't be a play bigger than that, Brad.
We're about ready to start the second half, Dick. Let's go down and see how this one unfolds. Baylor has made a statement by crashing the boards in the first half, Dick.
Very, very strong statement. They're letting the opposition know that they're not going to give them any second chance opportunities. And that speaks volumes, baby.
All right, let's check in third member of our team again. Here's Aaron Andrews.
Well, Brad and Dick, as you can imagine, both coaches were very intense as I met with them at halftime. They said at this point, it all comes down to playing their game, having fun, and enjoying the moment. Guys?
Thanks, Aaron.
I tell you, he missed the post guy. The post guy had the great angle, was locking on the box.
He beats him to the punch defensively.
What a terrific job. Footwork really excellent on a post play.
Goes up for two.
He took the defender into the screen, but couldn't get the inside shot to drop.
Worked the perimeter.
Spacing so important. Get 15 to 17 feet apart.
Off the rim and no good. Throws it up. Puts it up, looking for contact. Up, easy one.
The defender's doing a great job of applying ball pressure.
It's good. He dials long distance. The Terriers have found a player who cannot seem to miss, Dick.
They need to keep feeding the ball. It's simple. Run him right into the screen again. What did I say?
Sweet looking shot.
He is super. He really is.
Fakes the jumper. And he'll kick it back outside. That's a nice fake. For the bucket.
I tell you, once you get deep position like that, it's automatic.
On the dribble, gives it up. Up fake.
Great pressure, great double team. Really explosive.
Taken away. Here they come now on a turnover. Rims out. Dick, this is just playing good defense.
Really does a great job with his footwork, beating him to the spot.
He looks for three. Way off target. Number 13 is whistled for the foul. Dick, how's that backcourt comparison shaping up, do you think?
Hey, Brad, that's a question that these coaches should be asking themselves. How can they, as coaches, get the most out of their guards? Are they quick enough to pressure the opponent, or offensively, can they create off the dribble? To me, it's about finding the weaknesses and attacking them.
For two, finger roll. Off the lazy pass. Didn't give it to him down low. Going the other way. The three. The Terriers have got to continue to get him the ball.
And he's on fire. Soft defensively, no pressure on a basketball.
And with it, he blocks the shot. The ball goes out of bounds. That is is a great play. These kids have all the momentum now. Look at them. They're celebrating.
They're definitely having some fun out there.
Kicks it out. Gave it up. Got the shot if he wants it. And the ball goes out of play. You talk about a packed house. Look at this crowd.
I tell you, coach's dream, baby. This gives you that edge.
And has it rejected.
Defense did a great job with the blocked shot.
Drains it. Blows right by him.
That's the old Matador defense. Let the ball go through. Trying to get that ball movement, get that good spacing.
For the bucket. They still don't score.
Excellent spacing. That's so important to a good offensive set. It's even more important to have talented guards like they have.
Yeah, that helps.
Dumping inside.
The power forward takes the feed. Number one. That bucket counts, and he'll go to the line.
Hey, excellent job there. Drawing the foul and finishing the hoop.
He goes to the line for the first time. No doubt about it.
There's the trap.
Jumped in front to take it away. On the outside. He shoots from left of the circle. Going to be an offensive foul for sure.
What a great job defensively. What a super job. Great footwork. And he really draws the charge.
Looking for a good shot. He launches a three. Gets it to go.
That's an 8-0 run.
Defensively down on the low block, and there's a steal.
Terrific job anticipating, reading the offense, and making that steal.
On the dribble, gives it up for the deuce. Off the rim and no good. Nicky's working on that low block on that right hip.
I'll tell you one thing, he's trying to deny him the ball initially, but the defense really doesn't do a great job of sealing them off.
It's no good. Jump hook from the low block.
I tell you, he didn't waste any time. He got the ball in the right position, and then what it does, it keeps the defensive player away from blocking a shot when you make that turn. It looks as though they have a shooter spotting up.
Trying to draw some contact. He puts it in with contact and all. On the outside, the shooting guard takes the pass. And he'll kick it back outside.
Double team now, bad angle.
The point guard with the ball. Here's a nice face up down on the low block.
Oh, he did a great job face up and then just attacked them and took it to the basket.
Four, intercepts it. Gave it up. That spin move not successful, Dick.
I did a great job on the defense, not allowing them to make that.
Blocked. Nice job defensively. Had him in the low block, but opted against it. From way outside. He gets it to go. For two. Sweet looking shot.
He is super. He really is. Up and inside. Look at that spacing.
Fakes the shot. He takes the three. Can't put it down. Moving it around the perimeter. Tries for two. In and out. Takes away the pass. They'd like to get it inside to the low block. Unable to so far. Nice job of packing it in defensively.
Yeah, really doing a great job packing it in and a great job of anticipating that lateral pass.
Circle.
Nice job of using the screen to get open for that good shot.
Picked off. Tries for two. Can't get the shot to drop. He tries to knock down the three. Oh, yes! He shoots from long range. Off the rim and no good. Trying to come up with a steal, and they do. There's a double team waiting there. Steals the ball. The small forward gets the ball. Goes for the deep one. Poor decision there to shoot that three.
I don't think the coach wants him taking that shot.
Watch the defense down on the low block.
See, first, initially, he wants a three-quarter. Then he plays him where he gets good post position, so he's able to get the ball. The good rebound position, a good block out, and that's essential in the post. A lot of guys don't realize part of post play is ultimately a block out and get good rebound position.
Adam, momentary look from three-point land. Has it rejected.
Defense did a great job with that blocked shot.
Number, whistle blown, basket's good, and one.
That's concentration, baby.
They're feeling good. The momentum is on their side, and everything is falling into place. Their body language, Dick, says it all.
I'd celebrate too, partner. They are playing some great basketball at the moment.
He can't get one to fall. And that free throw line has really not been friendly for them tonight, Dick.
Yeah, they just haven't looked comfortable from there. Up and inside.
Way out on top, controlling the ball. Let's go courtside. What do you got for us, Aaron?
Well, Brad and Dick, an emotional message from both benches. Let's play our game. That's what got us here. And more importantly, let's believe in one another. Guys?
All right, thanks, Aaron.
This is the big time. Up, easy one.
Working it around the perimeter. The point guard gets the pass. Sinks it. Picked out of the air. On the dribble, gives it up.
Backcourt violation call.
A little bit of a mental lapse by the offense that time, Dick. He lets it go. The shot's off target. Reverses the ball after having a guy in the post. Fronts him first, Dick, and then works behind.
Yeah, he's playing from behind because that tells me right there they don't respect him as an offensive player. And they made an error, obviously. But they don't have the great respect, so they're saying, you know what? Let him get the ball and let him try to beat us.
Isolated on the outside. They work it around the arc, looking for the open jumper.
The pressure that basketball. Help one another. Communicate.
Goes up for two. And off the mark. He shoots from right of the circle. Baylor is showing a bit of a run here.
Things are going their way right now.
Work the perimeter.
Spacing so important. Get 15 to 17 feet apart.
Let's it fly. Great defense. Dickey's really sticking to his man defensively down there.
I tell you, doing a great job fronting him, trying to beat him to the spot, playing in front, making him throw the lob pass over the top. If you get help, you can take that pass away.
Up and inside.
He makes the block. Went away from the post and goes the other way. They go inside and now back outside.
I tell you, inside-outside action always works.
He rips the nets for another score.
He's absolutely unconscious.
Number 13 comes up with it. Is this defense ever quick to recover?
It's core conditioning, Brad.
Nice drop step.
I tell you, he does a great job with his footwork to create the drop step. Hey, this crowd will be ecstatic if they can get a basket.
Dick, how's he working him defensively?
I tell you, he's trying to front right now. You've got three concepts. You can play halfway, you can play behind, or in front. They've decided to play in front, which means you got to get help side.
Absolute mayhem. This place will be in disarray, Dick, if they can get a stop. Cross court. Tries the three. Rims out.
Brad, this crowd will be in a frenzy if they can get a basket on this possession.
The Bears are a stop away from hearing this crowd go senseless. Turnaround jumper. Boston University are on a run right here as of late, Dick.
Yeah, they've started to put it together on offense. Can they keep it together, though? That is the question.
There's the fake. The Bears have a mismatch in the post.
You're right, Brad. There is a mismatch.
Can't get the shot to go. And has it rejected.
Defense did a great job with that blocked shot.
intercepted. Moving it around the perimeter. In the paint. Number 13 is pounded on his way up. Oh, and he's not going to be happy with that call.
Well, silly foul right there, but look at his face. His facial expression tells it all.
Number 13 steps to the line for the first time. Makes the foul shot. Both free throws go. Timeout. We'll take one, too. We'll be back in a moment. See if they've decided to go in another direction with things right here, Dick.
It wouldn't kill them to get a little diversity in their play right now.
They work it around the perimeter.
High post screen. So effective, that screen.
Can't get it to go. His shot blocked from behind.
He set him up nicely.
Dickey's going to kick it back out there from down on the low block.
I tell you, a post player has to be able to read what the defense gives you.
He shoots from the top of the circle.
They're trying to build an entire neighborhood with all those bricks, Brad.
They need some buckets, and they need them in a hurry. For the bucket. Sweet-looking shot.
He is super. He really is.
Gave it up. For the deuce. Off the rim and no good.
Excellent spacing. That's so important to a good offensive set. It's even more important to have talented guards like they have.
Yeah, that helps. Baylor are doing a nice job of pulling a solid run together.
Hey, they're really starting to put an offense.
Timeout. Let's check in with Aaron, who's standing by.
Well, guys, this is a great opportunity for the coaches to calm their teams down. With this much time remaining, they're stressing play smart basketball and take care of the ball.
All right, Aaron, we're going to watch that the rest of the game. Well, let's see who will benefit the most out of that timeout, Dick.
Great pressure, great double team, really explosive.
Robs him of the ball.
Dump it inside.
Didn't like what he saw in the post and reverses the ball. He tries the three, rims out. Working around the perimeter. Jumped in front to take it away. Tries for two. Sweet looking shot.
He is super. He really is.
Picks off the pass.
That's winning energy, baby. The team with the most energy and execution goes home with the big W.
Has a nice look at the basket.
Foul them early and give your team a chance. There's the trap.
He goes for the trifecta. Drains the shot. change might be in order, don't you think, Dick?
I wouldn't be surprised if they changed things up a little bit, Brad.
And we're back to a two-point game. On the dribble, gives it up. Goes up for two. Sweet-looking shot.
He is super. He really is.
Play about ready to resume. Dick, the shots seem to be dropping for him right now.
I'll tell you one thing. They're dropping, and you better have good productivity out of your front court. When you have that balance inside-outside, you got a great chance to win. And you have to have post players that are going to make big plays.
At the end of the second half, it's a dead heat. These teams are going into overtime.
Dick, this is everything we could ask for. It's everything that basketball fans across the country can ask for. NCAA tournament game and overtime.
Hey, I'll tell you one thing. Does it get any better than this? You talk about awesome, baby. Overtime game in the NCAA tournament? Wow. How golden is that? Man, I'm afraid to hear this crowd. If they can get a stop on this possession.
Gave it up. On the dribble. Gives it up. Up fake. Number 14 is called for the foul. First team foul. As we take a look here at our backcourt production.
Hey, Brad, I'll tell you one thing. Productivity from the backcourt is a must. You must initiate the offense, distribute the ball, and score. These are all things that you rely on your backcourt to do.
Let's see if they can get a good shot this trip. Dickey's working on that low block on that right hip.
I'll tell you one thing, he's trying to deny him the ball initially, but the defense really doesn't do a great job of sealing him off.
That spin move not successful, Dick.
I tell you, great job on the defense, not allowing him to make that turn.
For two, let's check in courtside with Aaron Andrews. Aaron?
Well, Brad and Dick, as you know, points in the paint is a stat that coaches will readily look at, comparing their team's dominance in this category with opposition. Establishing that inside presence is an important facet of consistent success.
Thanks, Aaron.
I'll tell you one thing, she's essentially right. Down in the post is where you create a lot of offensive action.
He fires from long range. Off the rim and no good. Gave it up. He goes with a jump hook.
I tell you, didn't waste any time. He got the ball in the right position. And then what it does, it keeps the defensive player away from blocking a shot when you make that turn.
And Dick, this is just playing good defense.
Really does a great job with his footwork, beating him to the spot.
Let's watch the defense down on the low block.
See, first, initially, he wants a three-pointer. Then he plays him where he gets good post position, so he's able to get the ball. A good rebound position, a good block out. And that's essential in the post. A lot of guys don't realize part of post play is ultimately to block out and get good rebound position.
For the deuce.
I tell you, did a great job creating a good angle, too. When he goes up and under, he seals off the defensive player.
I tell you, he missed the post guy. The post guy had the great angle, was locking on the box.
Tries for two. Sweet-looking shot.
He is super. He really is.
Goes up for two. And off the mark. For two, rims out for the bucket, and he scores despite the hack. On the dribble, gives it up. Way out on top, controlling the ball. He seems determined to take the tough shot.
But they're not falling, and the offense is being totally taken out of sync.
We'll take the shot. Yes! Looks like we're ready to step back out onto the court. 7 points right now is the difference in this one.
Hey, Brad, 7 points is no safe haven. You got to keep pressing.
On the outside, picks off the lazy pass. Gave it up. Now they work it around the perimeter. There they come with a double team to stop it. Now the high screen. Wide open for the shot. And a momentary look from three-point land. 10 on the shot clock. Steal.
There's a steal.
For the deuce. Off the rim and no good. Well, it's time to start fouling. They got to stop the clock, Dick. Wow, Dick, let's check out that State Farm drive of the game.
Hey, what a great move, Brad. He was able to find an opening and finish at the basket. That's a great finish. Highlight material, baby.
Foul, and that stops the clock again. This crowd is unbelievable today.
Oh, they're emotional. They're packed. They're jammed. You can't find an empty seat.
You talk about a packed house. Look at this crowd.
I tell you, coach's dream, baby. This gives you that edge.
And yet another foul as they're just trying to hang on here. And yet another foul.
Nobody likes this point of the game, and the losing team is fouling in order to stop the clock.
So he'll get an opportunity to change the scoreboard again from the free throw line.
Well, he created a foul opportunity.
He makes the second shot. They'll take a timeout right here. Action's ready to start again. He attempts the three.
They need to foul here.
And they continue to foul to stop the clock. He goes to the free throw line. Misses the front end of the one and one.
This important possession if they want a chance to win.
Number 24 is asking the fans for even more encouragement.
You know, Brad, he wants the fans backing for this defensive possession.
Shot clock is dead. On the dribble, gives it up. And the clock stopped with a foul. That's probably why you're out of coaching. Too many points off turnovers.
I'll tell you one thing. That leads you to the exit sign. No question. You get the Ziggy. I'll tell you, you got to protect the basketball. You can't turn it over.
The Ziggy. Steals the pass. And yet another foul as they're just trying to hang on here. Number 24 goes to the line. Makes it. He makes his second shot.
All you need is a score to stop to have a chance.
5 points separate these two squads right now.
No one's leaving this building without a fight, Brad.
Makes it. Foul, and that stops the clock again. And there's a look at the foul situation so far.
Hey, knowing when to foul and when not to foul is a great skill to have. Coaches should always be communicating this with their team.
He hits the first. Makes both of them. Timeout on the court, so let's go courtside. Here's Aaron Andrews.
Brad and Dick, with limited time remaining, the coaches will have to figure out their offensive and defensive strategies for the next few possessions. What they will discuss or fail to discuss during this timeout could be the difference, guys.
Aaron's right about that. We might see a little different look this time, Dick.
You never know what's coming, Brad.
He launches the bomb. Got it. And the clock stopped with a foul. Well, Dick, there's a look at the foul situation.
Well, you know, Brad, a lot of times the first team to the bonus will get the advantage. That means they're playing aggressive basketball. It means they get to the charity stripe quicker and have an opportunity to rack up some easy points.
These kids are really struggling from the free throw line tonight.
I hope they can turn it around before it costs them the game.
Second one is good. With the shot, too strong. Dick, sometimes statistics lie, but in this tournament game, I don't think they do. The better team won, and they're going up.
Well, I tell you, won this game, Brad, when you look at it, analyze it, because they really had all the right people shoot the ball at the right moment. They did a terrific job offensively.
Baylor never fails to impress, as they did again tonight in this Final Four matchup.
I'll tell you, Brad, I think it's almost impossible to beat this team the way they're playing right now. We're going to find out tomorrow when it's all on the line as they play for the Solid Gold Trophy and the NCAA Championship title.
Brad Nessler saying so long for my partners Dick Vitale and Aaron Andrews. Thanks for joining us.